That's a very good question. And it's not an easy solution to come to. The schools as a whole, you know, council really doesn't have much authority there, but there are things that we can do to work better with them. We do know there's a lot of homeless kids in the CMS school system. And a lot of the times, the reality is this, we're not divided by nothing but income. If you have a certain income, you can live in certain areas. Unfortunately, a majority of people cannot afford to live in those areas. So they're forced to live what they can afford, and they're forced to go to the schools that are in those areas. What we need to focus on is getting more affordable housing closer to those areas. To get these kids out of the hotels, that's what someone talked about earlier, that is definitely a problem here. We should have no kids that are homeless in CMS. There's no excuse for that. So we need to look at everything possible to get as much affordable housing in the areas, because they're not going to bust the children to the areas. We've been down this road before. The school board is not going to do that. They've already said that. But they are looking at some other options that may help. We don't know what those are yet. We're going to see what the new school board consists of and see what their plan is. But we definitely need more affordable housing in our areas that have these children living in hotels. Nothing high, but some low mixed development, all income levels. That's the most important thing. No matter what your income is, you should be able to have a safe, clean place to live. We can do this. Charlotte has been the forefront of becoming the 17th largest city in the country. We can do that.
Me next? Thank you. Thank you for that question. I read to students at Winterfield Elementary and Devonshire Elementary, Title I school, lots of immigrant population there. I read to the second graders in the media center, and when they bring in those five classes of second graders, I count four or five white kids. So we have resegregated our school. And, you know, I know we're working with a task force now about upward mobility, but I think the real problem is the concentration of poverty that we have in this city. And the Mixed Income Housing Coalition a couple of years ago was real strong advocates of getting mixed income housing established around the city everywhere. But it's a voluntary plan. We may need to look in the Housing and Neighborhood Development Committee about what we want to do to entice that more, to incentivize more of that, or even make it a requirement to require developers to have X number of units to be for certain median incomes to come into that. But yes, we have other tools, but it's going to take the political will to pull them out and use them.
So I'm sure everybody's heard the phrase, it takes a village. Well, in this particular village, and as it relates to governance, the city council, our job is really kind of right on bricks and mortar. We do transportation, buildings, and those types of things. County commission does social services, parks and recs, and those things that are humanized. And then, of course, we've got the school board. My role in the village, and I still affect education, my role in the village, and my part that I play with the city is that, one, I need to make sure we have safe communities. Having police, having programs to assist and make sure that the kids that are going to our schools and are living in our neighborhoods have safe places to go to and walk to. My role in the village is to make sure we have affordable housing in and around all over Charlotte so that we don't get concentration of poverty in certain areas. My role in the city, in the village, is economic development. I need to bring jobs into the city so that people have an opportunity to feed their children, clothe their children so they go to school and they'll be proud of it. My job in the village, we'll see what else I'm doing in the village. My role in the village is to work with my counterparts in my district. I work with Belmont, and we try to solve problems. Also, take it to a high level. I work with my senator in the back here, Mr. Joel Ford, and Kel Alexander, to try to resolve problems. That's our role in the village. We all have to come together to affect education.
Most of it's already said, you know what the role of the city council is. Yes, in 2006, we went back to court. And that court said busing was no longer needed. And that resegregated our communities. The reality is that as we are able to create more diverse mixed income neighborhoods, that we have more stabilized schools. The role that I play as a council representative, even though some of us would love to say that we're going to get in and champion schools, that's not the wheelhouse that we sit in. But where we can play that role, as Councilman Austin just said, is in those partnerships. So you look at Reed Park Academy. You look at the fact that the neighborhood of Reed Park came together, and we now have done a groundbreaking for Reed Park Park. My role in that was to be at the table alongside my county commissioner, Ms. Vilma Lee, as well as Ricky Hall, who's the president, to say this is what we need for the community, but the community leads that charge. We cannot do mandatory housing. Yes, we have the political, if we had the political will, we could do it, but let's look at Durham County. When you look at the actual numbers, Durham County has mandatory inclusionary housing. They have not produced any major numbers of affordable mixed income housing. So yes, we can strengthen to try to sweeten the deal to get companies to come in, but I've asked for 3.5 years from our planning director down. Can I mandate this? No, I can't, but I can partner to make something different. I need your help today.
Let's just start with the schools. I know that we don't have policy. We don't have the ability to make any policy on school board. But as a person in the community, in District 3 is where I live, we have more Title I schools probably than any other district, I would say. And there's an enormous challenge. And on top of that, we have charter schools that are coming to play, which the revenue for charter schools are, to me, I think there should be a little bit more accountability and transparency when it comes to those. But our kids definitely, I think it starts at home when it comes to how these children are going to school, what they're actually learning. Because I have tutored in math and science in Devonshire over across town, also at Wilsonville School, also at Whitewater Academy. So when we look at these schools, our parents, the children of these parents, have to be able to make a living, and that means a living wage. And everybody who is presently city council, county commissioner, they need to support a living wage, because that's how we lift these kids up out of poverty. That's how we get them the programs that are needed, because if we continue to pay people $9.50 an hour, ask them to pay for their apartment along with their daycare, it won't happen. That's just simple math. We need to make sure that the people who are seated in city council and the county commission are supporting a living wage for working families.
The first answer to that is that it is on a Monday for a council. Okay. Well, the other part of that, I think I just explained in talking about our governance. Our governance is, and I talk about our village, our governance is roads, transportation, streets, and related back to how we affect education. I talked about the fact that in county commission, they relate to social services, parks, rest, and those certain things. The school board relates to that. Then I talked about how we as a council all relate together. I'm not quite sure if you were in the room and listening, but that's kind of where we are.
Let me say something. There are so many forums.
Yes.
Maybe
yes.
Some of them were not invited. So that's really an unfair question.